This is Beach Buggy Racing 2 Island Adventure. We're on Xbox Series X. The game is inheriting an Xbox One X enhancement. That means we're getting a 4K resolution at 60 FPS. This does also feature VRR, and it's got some neat features, so you can kind of play it by yourself, or surprisingly, local multiplayer of up to 8 players, which is kind of neat. So it has a variety of different modes, a variety of different ways to play, and it's got some fun action. So the first Beach Buggy game was actually something I quite enjoyed. I found it to be a fun little karting title at the start of the last generation. So it's actually kind of exciting to see this second one release kind of at the end of that generation, also at the beginning of the new generation. So you know, it's got different things. We'll start off by talking about the adventure mode. So this is kind of the story element of the game. You're moving through different levels trying to get, you know, there's like a 3-star system and you're trying to get the best stars, and then you get the stars to unlock new areas. You know, there's all these different locations that you're trying to kind of get to as you're working through these places. You're also able to gather basically these upgrades to fix up your vehicles and make them a little bit better, unlocking different characters, you know, kind of getting new customization options while doing this, stuff like that. You know, it gives you a lot of options and different ways to kind of play if you want something more structured. You can, of course, just do quick play. There's like championship events you can do as well with like trophy systems, race, drift attack, firework theory, all kinds of different game modes. You can also customize your own game modes if you want something a little bit more wild and unique to whatever sort of play or party system you have set up for you and whatever local people you want. I guess they do weekly tournaments on the leaderboards, lots of different unique racetracks. There's 23 unique worlds. They all have shortcuts, secrets, and hidden things. They actually do have fantastic variety in this. You get everything from easygoing kind of beach-type locations to driving through pyramids or basically tackling like weird ice-based levels. You know, they really go wild in this one, and I think it's a really good step up from the last one. In general, the whole game just feels a lot more polished and larger in scale. So you're able to collect and customize over 40 unique cars. They got everything from like monster trucks, moon rovers, race cars, and of course the classic beach buggies. 14 drivers that are present. You get all kinds of things. You'll see a few of them throughout the video here. And there's 44 individual power-ups in this one. It's absolutely insane, quite honestly. It is like the weirdest thing in the world having that many power-ups. Because every time I was like racing in one of these like kind of quick play setups to try out different like, you know, levels and different scenarios, it was like there was constantly new stuff coming up. And the different characters have different abilities too, different like things that help them out. It's just kind of nuts because there'll be like tacks on the floor, missiles getting sent, weird shields, random mystery things, balls that you're kind of throwing across the ground. And you know, obviously this is a karting type experience if you didn't really pick that up, but I think it definitely excels at doing the karting genre. You know, it's just got these really lovely environments and backdrops and, you know, a nice set of music to it, easygoing levels that have some levels and layers of complexity to them, different places you can go, different things you can see within them, and like I mentioned, you know, there's secrets and little hidden things that can help you out. The environments are also a little dynamic as well in regards to some of the things, like you can run over like a penguin and stuff and it reacts to you to you hitting it and stuff, and there's like crabs that go through the level, you know, different things like that in different scenarios. They really do mix it up quite a bit. And every single track feels entirely distinct in terms of its setup, its biome, its environment, the layering of the track. It's really actually quite interesting. And I had a lot of fun here. I think if you're coming off the first Beach Buggy, you'll be like, wow, this is a massive improvement. And if you've never seen this franchise before, you'll be like, oh, wow, this is actually pretty cool. And yeah, it's kind of fun. It's pretty simple to understand. I think it's great for any type of audience that's trying to jump into this one, especially the younger ones. There are difficulty options if you want more of a challenge or less of one. I thought the normal difficulty was very fair. A little bit hardcore when you're going into the quick play, though. It seemed a little bit more intense, the characters that I was racing against. But, you know, your mileage may vary. And of course, you can change difficulty, too. Entirely up to you and how you want to play it. Oh yeah, there, I smoked a penguin. That's kind of funny, just like, yeah, just hitting it. A little humorous because it's like the side thing, but there's just like chaos that goes on in this one. Like players with like AI and stuff is just like ruthless with all these abilities. And like I said, there's a whole stack of abilities in this one. There's all kinds of things going on, like grease stuff on the ground, flowers, shooting carrots, ghosting through things. It's crazy. It really is, and it's hard to, I guess, master them all, because there's so many, it'll take a while for you to get a hold of everything. There's stuff like makes you bounce high up in the sky, stuff like low gravity, health pack. Like, it's just, it's nuts. It really is. It handles well, though. The gameplay feels cool. You got, like, power slide options, a good selection of different modes that you can play through. I don't know, it's just kind of a really complete package that's filled with a good amount of content. I was pleasantly surprised. This is something I think I've been waiting for a while in regards to having heard of this one coming eventually. And alas, here we are. It's nice to see it come and actually have so much distinct content to it. I was like, oh wow, this is actually quite a lot of fun. Because like I said, I thoroughly enjoyed the first one back in the day. There was more they could have done with it at the time, but I think they really, really expanded the scope and the style of what is present here, which is, you know, just delightful to have available. I think that's really cool. And they're very open about it, so you could do, like, just so you know, like, I can do review-wise, I can do it ahead of time. They're very confident with this game, and it all seems to load and render quite well. I did notice, like, some minor little bits of popping and, like, the far distance. Like, it's stuff that most people won't ever notice. Like, small little shadow thing, like, off in the far distance, like, one or two items. So it's, like, so minimal. For the most part, it all runs very smoothly. It all looks quite impressive. You know, all the little environmental elements. Because it's not just the track you're kind of racing along. There's, like, this ambience. Waterfalls, flowing water, ice, animated creatures, all these effects flying across the screen. It's actually kind of amazing optimization wise in regards to just the crazy sort of things going on at once that are all impacting this, and it's just so smooth and such a step up from what I came from the first time. I still would like some online multiplayer elements. I really think that's a step that the series needs to take at some point. It would be really cool if they would be able to, you know, achieve that if there's a third one or something like that. I think that would have been nice. Even here would have been nice. But if you're doing couch co-op and stuff, you know, I think this is a really good one for racing with a lot of friends. It can get a little nuts, that's for sure. You could definitely have some fun surprises as you attack one another. And they just really put together a fun karting game. I've said this for quite a while, that we don't have enough options in this genre nowadays. I remember there being so many when I was younger, and you know, we still have quite a few that I can think of, but it would be cool if there were more like this type of game, because it's fun. It can be easygoing, it can be challenging, you know, it can really surprise you, I think. You know, there's a little bit of a technical element of, you know, getting a hold of how you kind of battle and how you drive and how you compete with others. But for the most part, it delivers everything almost flawlessly. There's a good amount of content if you're actually wanting to work through, like, the quote-unquote story-type mode. Or you could just do championships, or just quick play, or just play with friends, you know? You've got all these choices that are present here. It's fairly comprehensive, a great selection of levels, or, well, maps and tracks that you can race across. And it's, you know, visually fairly impressive. Now, it's not necessarily the most detailed on some of the smaller things. You know, it still has a very cool sort of cartoon aesthetic to it. But I really like that look, because it's sort of a simple, nice, easygoing type of atmosphere. And it just really, really hits the mark for me as being something a lot of, you know, that could be a lot of fun. Lots of customization, a lot of choice, lots of decision-making as you're driving about competing with others. I think they definitely hit the mark with this follow-up to it. And yeah, I look forward to maybe someday doing a review of the third one years from now, I guess. I have no idea. It's just like, you know, it kind of takes me back, because I remember reviewing this years ago, and now we're hopping into the second one. Time flies, right? You know? Actually, I'm surprised it took them so long to get this one kind of available on the platform. I would have assumed that they would have you know, kind of done it a little bit faster even, but no, it definitely was worth the wait, and the loading time's obviously super quick here, and yeah, I guess just enjoy some more gameplay if you want to see it in action, but that's all about all I've got to say for Beach Buggy Racing 2, The Island Adventure. Ooh.